I think Lulu is more OP. I think at this scenario, Lulu have Viego, Camille. I think Lulu is more OP at this scenario.
All right, so quick recap. You have the Trundle on the bottom side, Pillar, excellent interaction into an immobile AD carry like Ashe. Yes, probably won't get to
Silly
W.
Hope we go to game five because I want to hear Zen, Zara, Jakus, and Shox do another pick and ban. That was fantastic. Now, just before we continue to focus a little bit more, here it will be under some pressure. It flashes all the ability to jump forward onto Jhin, which is a low mobility bot laner. Inspired's making his way back.
They've
this is
the
bold.
Wave. The other one literally just crashed as well. They have two waves to play with. Vanda
stuck underneath the tower. The Pillar of Ice will buy some time. That's a Zenith Blade 4. The turret helping out a lot. First blood is already secured. Inspired was able to pick up the kill. Now he's stolen away the Trundle. Pillar of Ice comes out, copies the next target. Flawless dive thus far, but Trimby will get taken down. It's Cobby that picks up the kill. Vizio spins the teleport as well. 2-for-1 on the dive.
Yeah, that was so well played from Rogue. That's something that we've been looking for Misfits.
The Shield of Daybreak stun onto Cobby.
Yeah.
Easily lined up that second kill. And yes, he did get sacrificed, but it was able to get two. Now here at Flashless, remember, he's going to put some damage down onto Odo. Is enough to trade back in a 1v2 once again. But Inspired's Viego, 100% kill participation. Now the Pillar of Ice is thrown out. Teleport's being channeled. I believe that's Larson arriving to the fray.
And that's the difference between the two dives that we saw. One from Rogue, one from Misfits right now being attempted. Misfits had absolutely no wave, no minions to keep the aggro, nothing. And now Rogue can turn on to the aggressive.
Trimby, he's going to Hex Flash over. Larson's the target. Kill secured by Vizio, but at Razork's life. Hans Summer's not going to be able to pick up the kill.
Here
as it goes the way to Trimby. Pillar of Ice locks Trimby inside. He manages to walk up. Finally, second kill picked up. This time it's for Hirit. That is what Misfits needed.
Yeah, absolutely. And Hirit has his lane frozen, if I'm not wrong, against him right now in the top lane to get something for his troubles.
I think that's important to call out because, of course, Hirit on that Jace, if he does get damage down, and look, he's already starting to bully Odo, he can unlock the Jhin pick, the Vizio flanks, the Razork engages. And look at this, Vizio, Razork.
Rogue has no vision of this.
3v2, no teleport for Larson. The engage comes out, Hextech ultimatum, there's no support. Here it's been left alone. He flashes away to safety and here comes Vizio, looking for the Mimic, dashes forward, that's another kill. Wimbledon's Lightning comes out and is the chase continuing? Razork with an audacious charge. Here it puts the hammer down and it's two more kills to Misfits.
So beautifully executed by Misfits. That was absolutely no scene. I don't think Larson was in lane early enough to push out the wave, so Vizio is gonna lose nothing off that mid lane. Ace need to snowball way ahead, and they're already on their way to do that.
Well, Misfits, 1,000 gold, correction, 500 gold up. My math was way off. And this time, because of just how badly this bottom lane is going, Rogue are able to pick up the first dragon of the game the first time this series. But the inverse is true up top. Razork got Herald, has already dropped that very early on, trouble. And that's going to be helping out Hirit with that charge. I think that'll secure the tower as well. And it does. So Hirit gets accelerated even further.
All eyes on bot side as well, because the top side of the map is for Rogue. You have Larson on Lulu. He's chilling on a supportive mate. You have Odo Amner. He's been pushed back. He lost his tower so early into the game. He has been put behind.
Saying, yes, we're going to game five. That means Misfits have to close this out. They need to maintain this lead. Vanda gets caught by the enchanted crystal arrow. Not the target Rogue were looking for.
Trimby doesn't have ult. Hansama doesn't have ult.
Vizio's jumping onto Larson. Needs to go back to the distortion. Inspired. Not going to be able to do enough. Vizio's flashed away from that Zenith Blade. Wild Growth has already been used. Cobby can call the curtains back. He's holding onto the trigger. The first kill goes the way of Razork. The teleport comes in from Odo. Now Misfits with a kill advantage and control. They set their sights on the Dragon.
That is so important because Curtacall is still up and available for Cobby if he wants to zone them out with the ultimate. And on the side of Rogue, the only one with ultimate available is now Trimby because it just came up. I think that was extremely optimistic for Rogue trying to go in for that play right there. Solo.
They are still maintaining the 2,000 gold lead and they do need to defend this top tower from at least three members for now.
Very clever. They had seen that Vizio is, and of course Hirit picking the Jace, and the Jace is going to be I think so influential in the fights to come. One shock blast lands. That is the go button for Vizio to go and finish whoever is pressure without necessarily overextending. As you can see, the gold goes higher and higher and higher. Misfits are playing sort of how we expect Rogue to play.
Yeah, that level of control and pressing their advantage. I mean, when you highlighted the vision difference, Rogue did not see shit. This time round, the engage comes into Razork, Solar Flare comes out, the Wild Growth still available for Larson. in the ensuing fight. There's no Hirit yet. There's no shot loss. Inspired, can he break the hearts of the bunnies? Flash forward, defensive flash from Razork. He's escaped for now. Van is trying to buy some additional time. The heal comes out. Razork still stays alive. Now all of a sudden, Vito re-engaged from Hirit. Inspired's going to avoid the chains, but he cannot avoid the flourish. Cobby's called back the curtain, lands the shots onto Trimby. Now he's the next target here as Misfits continue the chase. Wild Growth finally used, rooted in place as a deadly flourish sends Trimby to the fountain. Misfits find themselves 2 kills and 20 seconds to Dragon.
Odoamne did not.
These things shouldn't be able to happen. Rogue's consistency and strength in the early game, it has been challenged. It has been interesting how that's happened, but it's been Misfits' individual skirmishes and individuals.
They're pulling to peace on him.
Up. Here it's going to be the target. 600 gold is the bounty. He gets turned into a little munchkin, and it is Inspired that picks up the kill. That's big.
What's on the map right now? Nothing's on the map for the taking except the Baron, and Rogue cannot go. Lulu's shields are going to be destroyed. And as much as we say that Ashe is very safe from Villeblanc due to Wit's End, due to the shield bow,
locked inside the baby cage. Vito's going to go down once again. The thing is, that's another shutdown. The thing is, trouble Misfits cannot.
You're dead.
Yeah, and we saw that as well, that previous fight. Here it was able to chunk Larson for probably like 30, 40% of his hit points. Well, potential engage, yep. If Kavi uses the curtain call, that will be the ghost signal.
Oh, he's gone!
Deadly flourish, all of a sudden, Vito's dead! He's blown up from all the CC! Misfits cannot afford for that to go wrong, but here it's got so much damage. Trimby's already down, they've traded one for one. Dragon is now available.
Ultimate and the only thing they're missing is the arrow, so they don't necessarily have to fight. All they have to do is pull the trigger for the Baron, force Misfits to fight into them again.
It's the Baron pit. Here it will just play whack-a-mole. And just be knocking
Vito,
down
yeah.
each of the rogue members so that the risk.
We're talking about real bonk.
Yes. Tools to stop a single target, right?
But not when Misfits, you're playing from so much distance that Misfits are playing from, though.
Yeah, that was the big thing, is that as long as Hirit and Kobi.
They're doing Baron right now.
That is what will allow Misfits
and that's
to
fast.
The advantage. Baron is going down low. Ash Arrow not going to find a target, 3,000 hit points, and Spike can make it inside the pit. Heartbreak has already been used, but so has the ultimate from Razork. The engage comes out, Vito jumps forward, and Spike manages to use a stopwatch to go golden. Curtain Call comes back from Cobby's firing out shots. First of all, is inspired. That means there's no smite. Baron's 2,500, but he's
down
as well. That's a gigantic turnaround. Baron's below 1,100, 1,200. Who's going to focus it down? Cobby's on a killing spree. That's a kill onto Razork. Now all of a sudden, inside the pit, Misfits managed to pick up Baron, but that was very, very close.
I was holding my breath right there. So they make sure they're in between the waves.
And of course, with a minute to Dragon, this squadron allows them to peel back for Soul.
Absolutely.
As soon as it comes up. That's Trimby. He's going to hop over the wall, engages with the Zenith Blade, copies the target, forced to flash away. Copies goes along.
Dead.
Finally taken out as Inspired gets the kill. The Crescent Guard knocks members of Rogue backwards,
what's
but Razork is untouched. Next one to fall will be Hirit. Vito needs to do something, but he's running away. This is a 2-for-1. Now Vito looking for the re-engage. Manages to pop Odo. This is a 2-for-2. All of a sudden, Rogue cannot continue
tower-wise from that Baron, but what that will allow them is getting an Ocean Soul, and that's so important for the trading patterns.
Gigantic. Absolutely gigantic. Do you change sides for the first time? Do you stick on blue? There are so many additional thoughts that you need to figure out the answer on. But Misfits need to get this Nexus down before we can answer them. The Ash Arrow goes wide. Solar Flare doesn't find a target. This time around, Kobi and Hirit are on the back line. BTO gets jumped on by an Awakening. That's immediately deletion. Curtain Call to close out the game, to shut down Rogue in game 4. That is what Kobi's looking for. That's a double kill for Hirit, another for Azork.
They have the wave, they can end right now and push this into game number 5. Misfits are breaking the curse of losing to Rogue all year long.
Misfits will be knocking down the Nexus, forcing game 5, and be one Nexus away from the World Championship. This series, the games that we have seen today, were not supposed to go this way.
They had the exact same push where they got punished. The difference maker in that last push is that the Trundle and the Xin Zhao were in the front line.